Čia jo angliškas bus video, tai bet pažiūrėsim pradžioje tą trumpį video, biškai background informacijos, pavyzdžiui.
Is the European Union really undemocratic, too slow, or overburdened by bureaucracy? These are some of the most common criticisms lobbed at the EU, and there's a grain of truth in them. Imagine this, a small country, maybe home to just 9.6 million people, has the power to throw a giant wrench in the works for the entire continent of almost 450 million people. That's right, just one tiny member state.
Pala, kas vyksta čia? Aš... Ok, pala, užpausinsiu video, man reikia išsiaiškinti, aš nemačiau, kas čia ką rašė. Nu, vienas žmogus tai mountą gavo, aš pasitikiu tada moderatoriais. Aš nesekiau čato, jeigu jūs man kažką rašėt ar ten tarpusiai susipykote, tai mountus galima uždėti ir tiek. Žinokit, jeigu norit pasipykti ir pasiginčiat, prisijunkite į Discordą. Balsu, pašnekėkit. Pozicijos gali būti visokios. Svarbu čatose, nespaminkit komentarų, tipo, kad kažką pasieksit iš to. Tiekit balsu šnekėt. Gerai, žimtuliu.
Can say no thanks and veto decisions, effectively hitting pause on progress for everyone else. Sounds a bit off, right? Or picture waking up one day to the news that someone you've never heard of is a new...
Na, kiek iš viso Europoje europarlamentarų yra, blėt, aš žinau tą skaičių. Ten didelis skaičius. 500 plus? Kiek jų yra?
President of the European Union. Surprised? Well, so were many Europeans in 2019, because the decision to elect von der Leyen
72, ne 75, 75, okay.
Ein came out of nowhere. The process of selecting the EU president often happens behind closed doors, shrouded in secrecy. Sounds like a democratic gap, right?
Okay,
but what
okay,
if things
okay.
could change?
Neskaičiau,
the upcoming election on June the 9th could be a huge turning point, depending how you...
Na, tai čia vienas tas klausimas. Ar tegu išrenka, tipo, už uždarų durų... nu, atstovai tą, ar labiau tipo demokratiškai, ar tada veto. Čia tie du, kur iš tikrųjų buvo tam klausimynė, tie du tokie esminiai klausimai, Europos Sąjungos kryptis. Okei. Okay. Tai aš šiuo metu linkstu, kad neturėtų veto viena šalis tiesiog turėti tokiais svarbiais klausimais, o pasirinkimu, kad vis dėlto ne žmonės tiesiogiai turėtų rinkti. Man atrodo, palikit išrinkti tiem žmonėm, kuriuos mes išrenkam, kurie iš tikrųjų nusimano daug geriau, kaip ten viskas veikia viduj.
You vote. Changing the EU fundamentally means altering its treaties, essentially the constitution of the EU. A proposal to amend the treaties is currently making its way through the EU, aiming for some radical changes, such as removing the veto vote and changing the way we elect our president. But as is normal in politics, there are parties in favor and against. The EU houses seven major political groups, each composed of national parties from across...
Apala. Septynios yra major political grupės, politinės grupės ten. Čia gal kaip Lietuvoj koalicijos gal, ar frakcijos gal, nežinau kaip čia pavadinti, nu grupės tarkim. Ir kiek žinau, Lietuva, bent jau mes, aš tą esu daug matęs, EPP, ta People's Party, kaip plėt, nematau, The European Parliament Group, ne. Kaip EPP išsiverčia? EPP... EU... Kaip ten yra? European People's Party. Ai, taip ir yra, man atrodo, jo. Lietuvos vėliava in reverse. Kad nėra in reverse? Geltona spalva tai saulė, žalia tai laukų spalva, raudona spalva tai kraujas, kartu jos tai Lietuva. Ne, ne taip, kas, ką sakai? Mūsų žalstiečiai veto labai sieks išsaugoti blokuos gamtos sauginės direktyvas. Buvo power outage? Oh shit. Tai gerai, tai... O gerai, man klausimas dabar yra. Ar... Visi 11 Lietuvos narių priklauso vienai, ar tiesiog šalis gali turėti pasiskirstusius, ar jie visi pasiskirsto. Kuriuose mes turim kiek lietuvių, man čia dabar irgi įdomu. Ar yra, pala? Political groups of the European Parliament. Spectrum. composition. Galima šiek tiek. Kas kur nori skirtingai gali, ok, nu, that makes sense. O dabar kaip man pažiūrėti, kuriai priklauso visi pas mus, kurie dabar yra... European People's Party, pavyzdžiui, tad nueinam. Ir pažiūrėm... Rasa Juknevičienė Vice Chair yra. O... Kan... Lietuvų... Tu gal čia numeti geresnį biškininką? Blet. Ok, kas jai priklauso iš Lietuvos. Au! Au! Ok, dėkui. Jo. Tai, pavyzdžiui, jo. Štai politiniai grupiai EPP, tai priklauso Liudas Mažylis, Seibutytė, Mandikienė, ok, Kubilius, Juknevičienė. Ok, tada Group of Progressive yra Juozas Olekas ir Blinkevičiūtė, kaip šita. Progressive Alliance of Socialists... Įsijungiam, tai čia SND, Socialists and Democrats, tipo, socialdemokratai jie taip vadinasi, ne? Tai čia, make sense, Blinkevičiūtė ir Olekas. Ar čia yra kažkokios ekstra labiau info trumpos summary? Ne, man dabar, I guess, kol kas dar nesvarbu, tai yra Renew Europe. Oi, pažiūrim, Renew Europe, mes turim Auštrevičių. Pažiūrim trumpai, Liberal Pro-European Political Group of the European Parliament, founded for the 9th European Parliament term. Ideology, liberalism, social liberalism, ok, čia. A, jis pristatys, davai pažiūrim jo, tada pažiūrim, paskui žiūrėjau.
Across the entire EU, and each has distinct views on these reforms.
Some advocate vigorously for change,
while others remain staunchly opposed. Let's visually...
Tai ECR maždaug konservatyvus prieš change'ą? Ok, pažiūrim.
We map these groups on a spectrum, from champions of EU reform to those firmly against it,
oh,
and see where each group stands. First up, meet Renew Europe. They're the liberal cheerleaders of the EU. They dream big about revamping the EU. No more vetoes on foreign policy and taxes. A stronger parliament. And even having a single EU president directly elected by the people, like you and me. Plus, they want EU citizens to vote directly for EU political parties. So we'll have to place them way over on the right of our reform spectrum. Now onto the ECR group, the soft Euroskeptics of the bunch, made up of right-wing conservative parties across the EU.
Tai aš sakyčiau, tie Renew Europe, gal man biški per radikalus? Man idėjos tos gal ir patiktų, o gal kaip tik man ne, gal aš šitose pozicijose irgi radikalesnis būčiau. Jeigu mes einam prie labai vieningos Europos, už ką aš techniškai kaip ir man patinka ta idėja, nu, kaip čia vos ne kaip viena federalinė jo... Tai gal tada aš būčiau biškai irgi tą pusę tada, nu tikrai ne euroskeptikas, tai tikrai nesu ECR, tai aš tada toj...
These guys are not fans of change. They see EU treaty changes as the big EU trying
bet
to push around member states.
Ar čia, ar man yra skirtumas, už kuri grupė man labiausiai tik... A, yra, aš paskui galėsiu, kurie dabar, pažiūrėjau, yra galėsiu jos reitinguoti aukščiau.
They're all about keeping the veto, keeping the EU parliament from getting too powerful, and definitely no EU-wide government or election. Their philosophy? Do less, but better. Therefore, we will place them at the very left of our spectrum. Next up, let's chat about the EPP, the center-right heavyweights, and the largest group in the parliament. They can be a bit wishy-washy with their plans. Sure, they flirted with the idea of treaty change before, but you won't find it spelled out in their latest manifesto. Ursula von der Leyen, one of the EPP's stars, plays it cool by saying she's open to treaty change, if and where it's needed. They say they want a more democratic EU, and are all for scrapping the veto vote on sanctions. But ask them for specifics on foreign policy, or how to pick the commission president? Crickets. So we're placing them smack in the middle of our spectrum. moving on to the left group in the European Parliament, made up of the furthest left parties across Europe. They support EU reform and want to embed anti-fascist values right into those treaties. Talk about setting the tone. But that's not all. They want a stronger parliament that can draft laws, select the commission, and even manage the budget. Yet they're not ready to say adios to the veto just yet. Therefore, we will place them slightly more to the right than the EPP on our reform spectrum, as their plans are simply more concrete. Shifting our focus to the S&D group, another powerhouse in the European Parliament, composed of center-left parties. They are staunch advocates for treaty change, to strengthen the European Union. Their
sex and drugs.
Vision to empower both the EU Parliament and the Commission and remove the veto on tax matters, pushing for more uniform fiscal policies across member states. They have also indicated removing the veto vote for foreign policy. Given their stronger stance on vetoes, we'll position them on the right of the left group on our reform spectrum. Moving on to the IND group, composed of the furthest right parties across Europe. This one will be quick. They're staunchly against treaty change, fearing it paves the way to an EU superstate. Their preference? Less power to the Commission and more power to the member states.
Of course,
they insist on retaining the veto power to safeguard national sovereignty. Therefore, we will put them on the very left on our scale, next to the ECR, who has similar opinions. And lastly, we have the Greens and European Free Alliance in the European Parliament. For the many Volt viewers that watch this channel, Volt currently also sits with the Greens in the European Parliament. And therefore, it should come as no surprise that they're all about moving forward with a more integrated and federal Europe, and therefore strongly support treaty change. They want a stronger EU Parliament that can propose legislation, elect the Commission President, and monitor EU spending. They are keen to see the EU take on more responsibilities in health, tax, and social protection. They also advocate for the removal of veto rights in areas like tax, foreign policy.
Nu, iš tikro, no joke, aš čia visai pritariu tom pozicijom, aš ir veto gal remove veto tax issues, nu, aš ne tik tax, bet tipo, ar remove veto foreign policy, aš tam pritariu, tax aš nenusimanau, bet tipo, man atrodo, aš tada biškį būsiu šalia turinių ir žalių šitų.
And the use of Article 7, which deals with breaches of core EU values. This firmly faces the Greens on the very right of our spectrum, next to the Liberals. Now here
Okay. Lamba, EPP, tada aš nežinau, man... Jo, čia jie klaustukus, tai nes jie nežino jų pozicijų, tai what the fuck, aš noriu žinoti savo pozicijas. Ir blemba, aš esu biškuka už tai, kad Europa turi gal biškį labiau keistis, ar, nu, bet judėti į linkmę, kur, tai aš tikrai einu į tą pusę, klausimas, kiek į tą pusę, žinai.
Have the view of our spectrum based on their manifestos. But what about their voting records? In November last year, a reform proposal went through the EU Parliament.
Ar yra kur nors deklaruota, į kurią pat partiją kandidatai norėtų eiti? Ar jie turi kur nors parašyti? Visi iš sąrašų, pavyzdžiui. Nes čia, man atrodo, tada gan svarbus kriterijus yra dabar žiūrinti šitą. Aš net nežinau, kad tiksliai taip veikia. Nes tai tada, man atrodo, man tikrai padės reitinguoti ir partijas, ir kandidatus paskui po vieną.
And here's how the political groups voted. Green is for, red is against.
Palauk, ko šia klausimas buvo?
But their voting records. In November last year, a reform proposal went through the EU Parliament. And here's how the political groups voted. Green is for, red is against, and white is abstained. So the most pro-treaty reform groups were the Greens/EFA, followed by the S&D, and then Renew Europe. On the other hand, the ECR and the IND were the most against. This also brings an important update. Although the left was initially positioned favorably towards treaty change, their actual voting record shows they're kind of against it. So we'll switch them with the EPP, who are clearly more in favor. And now let's
blamba, tas EPP toks centras grynas, aš nenoriu būti visai centro tokio, aš labiau norėčiau, kad davai mėginam judinti, o ne fansiteriai būnam. Mes, man atrodo, dabar neturim sau leisti tiesiog fansitint, man atrodo, mes turim priimti sprendimus. Ir aš noriu, kad tie sprendimai būtų geresnis, stipresnis ir daugiau Europos, tipo.
Variable. Which party support EU enlargement? Well, with the exception of the Identity and Democracy Group, all parties back the idea of enlargement, agreeing that it's long overdue. However, there are some caveats. Each party emphasizes that candidate countries should meet the necessary criteria to join. But the left specifically adds that human rights must also be upheld. Furthermore, the SND, Greens, and Liberals stress that enlargement is only feasible alongside significant reforms. So when it comes to championing EU reform and enlarging, the most proactive parties are the Greens, the Liberals, with the SND not far behind. Casting your vote for any of these groups would be a strong endorsement for EU reform. However, the differences between them lie more in other policy areas. For instance, the Greens are the strongest on environmental issues. The SND excel in advocating for social issues, and the Liberals focus on a robust defense. On the opposite end of the spectrum...
Ну, блин, эй, насау. Если бы была грешна тот галопайжи, ну и щита журент. Change president election process. Аж не знал, раз уж тебе реки покейсть, типа, матро даже не уж ты эсу. Bet šitas neaišku. Šitas tiesiog, I don't know.
Casting your vote for any of these groups would be a strong endorsement for EU reform. However, the differences between them lie more in other policy areas. For instance, the Greens are the strongest on environmental issues. The SND excel in advocating for social issues. And the Liberals focus on a robust defense. On the opposite end of the spectrum, if you're completely against EU reform, the ECR and IND might align more with your views. This is what we think. We've been very clear about our stance from the beginning. Removing the veto vote is a critical challenge the EU needs to address swiftly. The EU's indecisiveness, often caused by individual small member states, hinders our collective ability to move forward, especially in foreign policy and defense. Our motto is this: if we, whether German, Dutch, or Italian, don't cede a little sovereignty to the EU voluntarily, over which we have control through our vote, we risk losing a whole lot more to foreign actors like Russia, China, and the USA involuntarily, over whom we have no control. Today's video is sponsored by the European Federalists, who advocate taking the concept of EU integration a step further.
Okay, блин, okay, čia buvo geras video. Tai man actually reiktų, tai kai jau partiją susiaurinsiu kelias savo bent jau, nu aš jau susiaurinau šiaip, tai reiktų iš tikrųjų žinoti, kurią jie ta partija eis. Gerai, tai tą video pažiūrėjom, tada čia yra popular, ne laitės, okay, tai pažiūrėsim keletą tų video, pažiūrėjom, Climate Change and EU Reform Greens Plan for Europe, tai čia palaš gal jungsiu tą video vėl, tą grafiką, kuris gražiai kur nors matės.
The Greens and Liberals.
Nu, šiek gražiai matės, nu, tarkim. Tai Greens šitie labiausiai dešinėje. Nu, ne, aš nežinau. Ir Laisvės partija man gerai skamba. Ir Liberalų sąjūdis realiai. Ir Demokratų sąjunga techniškai, ir TSLKD. Tai vat aš nelabai žinau, aš tos keturis turiu. Bet anyway, dabar mes pažiūrėsim Greens, kuri į dešinę labiausiai šitam grafiką, kur realiai jau už visus tos pro Europe pasisako. La, LPP ir The Left. Kas yra LPP? EPP, tu turi minį? Ai, klaustukai neapkist vietom. Nes, jo, EPP su klaustukai žymėjo prieš tai. Aha, aha. Jo, tiksliai, jo. Nes jau prieš tai žymėjo ir neapkeitė. Oh, well. Gerai, tai pažiūrim tada tos Greens jų video.
We are going to deliver on climate policies. We are going to reduce your cost of living. We are going to invest in...
Prieš tai dar palam. Renew Europe čia jo. Ne, čia ne Renew Europe, čia tie Greens, kurie... Greens European Alliance, jo, šitie. Chaired by Philip Lamberts. Čia ne jis. Ir Terry, ai ne, ir Terry Reintke, o kas čia toks? Lead candidate European Greens, ok. Tai tie Greens, kiek jie turi, pavyzdžiui, 72. Ne pati didžiausia tikrai, bet ir nemažiausia. Ai, ketvirta pagal kiekį, ok. Frakcija, tarkim, taip gal vadinti, nu, bet jo grupė ketvirta. Nu, nors čia labai mažai skiriasi nuo, kad ir penktos ir šeštos tipo. Okay, pasiklausom.
In our green economy, we will make sure you keep your freedom. And very important, we will not bow to the pressure of populists and Putin friends. We as Greens stand for where we are. Choose courage, choose green.
Bas Eckhout is a prominent leader within the Greens and European Free Alliance group in the European Parliament. This group brings together three main factions with similar ideologies from all across the EU. First, there's the European Greens, which includes parties like the German Greens, France's Europe Ecology, and the Swedish Green Party. They're all about green left-wing politics. Next is the European Free Alliance, representing ethnic minorities and separatist movements, including parties like Belgium's New Flemish Alliance and the Spanish Republican Left of Catalonia. And then there's Volt Europa, a pro-federalist pan-European party. They operate across multiple EU countries with a unified platform, making it easier for...
Pala, ką reiškia Volt Europa? Kaip čia suprasti? Kas tas... Volt čia įmonė turi grupę savo? Kaip tai veikia? Kaip tai veikia? Čia bet kas gali sudaryti tą grupę ir tada, nu, jeigu nori jungesnį, tai ką reiškia, ką jie reiškia? Voltec, jo. The Volt symbol V is the unit of... Nu, ok, supratau. Jo, I'm not sure, čia jau.
Voters in any participating country to support Volt's consistent continent-wide agenda. Lastly, the group also includes independents, like the pirate parties, who sit with the...
pirate parties, pala, gal čia rašo? Volt Europa, yo, what the fuck is that? Kas čia per darinys, tipo? European parties. Pro-European and European Federalist Political Party, often self-referring to a movement, which is organized as a pan-European umbrella for subsidiary parties of the same name and branding in all EU member states. Jo, čia toks kaip darinys, bet kaip tai veikia tada Europos parlamente? Tokia kaip interesų grupė čia gaunas vos ne. Tokia grinai gaunas kaip interesų grupė, kur tada, nu, iš daug šalių, netgi ne Europos šalių tokia. Ir jie tiesiog kaip interesų grupė toj frakcijoj. Kažkaip čia įdomiai. Jie čia mažai ką rašo man naudingo apie tai, kas tai techniškai yra. Ok.
The Greens/EFA, but aren't affiliated to a European party. Covering this group is super challenging though, as each party has their own manifesto, without any shared priorities listed for the next election. In this video, we'll therefore focus on the Greens manifesto. Basically, if you vote for any of these parties on the screen, you're kind of voting for the Greens' master plan for Europe, which we'll dive into now, starting with defense. The Greens support NATO and Ukraine, advocating for ongoing financial and military aid. They envision an EU security union that focuses on military interoperability and procurement, and enhance cybersecurity to fight disinformation. They also push for reducing dependencies on authoritarian regimes and stopping arms exports to such leaders. In the Middle East, they advocate for renewed negotiations towards a two-state solution with secure, recognized borders. However, defense really doesn't seem to be the prominent issue for the European Greens. It really lacks detail in their manifesto. It's not among their top 12 priorities.
Yeah, aš ko gal nelabai suprantu, kai aš klausiu, šiarašat, kas man neatsako į klausimą. Kaip tada tos grupės susidaro? Nu, tipo... mes išrenkam parlamento narius, okei. Okay. Ir tada tu techniškai gali grupę bet kokias turėti, bet joj gali būti tik parlamento nariai. Bet čia, kaip suprantu, yra ne tik parlamento nariai. Tokia gaunas kaip ir šalis, net kur nėra Europos, kur... Tai čia interesų grupė tokia grinai gaunas. What? Man tas nelabai aišku, how the fuck, kaip tai veikia kaip darinys, kaip jis susidarė, iš vis kaip darinys. Jo. Ne, Volt yra partija. Nu jo, bet jis priklauso grupiai tų žaliųjų, bet tik toj partijoje, nu tai kas yra, žmonės ne parlamento nariai tada? Ką reiškia ne šalies Europos? What? Tai kaip jie gali rašyti, kad ten yra netgi šalių, kur nėra Europos Sąjungai? Kaip Ukrainos ir panašiai. Pala. Ai, ne, pala, ne. Which is organized. Čia yra jinai party, bet jinai organized as a pan-European umbrella for subsidiary parties of the same name and branding in all. Ai. Europos parlamente, ta partija yra Europos parlamento narių. Bet tas Volt Europa yra ir kitose šalyse, tipo. Tai techniškai jinai gaunas kaip ir toks, kaip aš dabar suprantu, tipo, nu, partija didelė ir bent jau dalim viena koja yra Europos Sąjungoj, bet ta pati kaip partija, jinai atstovauja dar ir kitas šalis, gal ir kitų šalių tos interesus, bet pro tą vieną koją Europos Sąjungoj ir žaliųjų toj grupiai. Maždaug šitaip veikia. Okei. Okay. Okei. Okay, makes sense.
And is only briefly mentioned towards the end of their 46-page document. They do call for a feminist foreign policy, though, that prioritizes gender equality and human security. A stance that at this moment really does raise some questions about its effectiveness.
Metro septim duchas.
And deterring aggressive international actors like Putin. Next is one of the hottest topics in Europe, migration. The Greens advocate for a humane asylum system that upholds human rights and offers protection to those in need. This includes people displaced by climate crises and LGBTQIA+ asylum seekers. They advocate for decentralized migration procedures and a mandatory relocation mechanism to distribute asylum responsibilities evenly across EU
members. Yeah, put in August. Putins, hai, tai jis manė kaip pečių duchas, pala, jis metras šiam 2 metrų 7, jo, apie metrų 7, jisai mažas gnomas yra, plėt, plėt, aš mes kažkada iš to, tipo, metrų 7 ir lopas toksai, vat, tiek pasaulį gali skausmą sukelt. God damn it, ir primeta ten galiūną, meškas, jodinėja, nu, tipo, what the fuck, tu metro septim, seniuk. Nu, tipo, vėlgi, čia toks stumimas ant ūgio, bet, tipo, diktatorius, kai toksai tokį primeta, mažės maros, rašo Google'į, man atrodo, apie metro septim, sunku gal nustatyti būna, taip, tiksliai, bet, yeah.
States. The Greens advocate for an EU-funded search and rescue mission in the Mediterranean to save lives at sea. They also want to enhance oversight of Frontex, the EU's border security organization, to ensure humane and ethical practices are upheld. They're also against unethical migration agreements with dictatorial regimes, such as the one of Tunisia, insisting any migration cooperation must include thorough human rights assessments. Furthermore, the Greens champion family reunification, work opportunities, and access to education and language training for asylum seekers. And they're committed to combating human smuggling.
Va, pavyzdžiui, jie skamba nuostabiai. Jie skamba nuostabiai, ne, kai taip pat išvardini. tu esi visiškai saugus ir nori kurti utopiją. Tame yra problema. Mes dabar nesam toje pozicijoje, man atrodo. Kad mums... Bet va čia klausimas, nu tipo... Klausimas, ką, nu, netgi dabartinės problemas sprendžiant, mes turbūt turėtumėm turėti omeny, kaip reikurta utopija, kaip mūsų tie sprendimai dabar privestų, nu, į tą pusę. O ne neatsižvelgti, nes dabar yra svarbesnių dalykų, tai reiškia, neatsižvelgiam dalykus, kaip ten, nežinau, žmogaus teisės, kad, pavyzdžiui, vėliau kažkada atsižvelgs, tipo, irgi ne. Nu. Ajajajajaj.
And then there's the big one, climate change and energy.
Because EPP and the Liberals are wrong when they say that the Green Deal is something that goes against our economy. The Green Deal is going to be the basis of a future economy that is built within the boundaries of this planet, that is built on social justice, and that is the kind of economy that we are going to fight for in this election campaign.
Climate change is the Green...
Kuri partija... Kuri partija man suteiks didžiausius šansus toliau nedirbti gyvenime rimto darbo. Už tuos balsuoju.
Top priority. They aim to exceed the 55% reduction in emissions target in 2030 and want to achieve climate neutrality by 2040. They believe these efforts will not only grant...
Palauk, čia manęs klausia, kam apie opt-in, aš nežinau net apie ką tu kalbi.
Dependence from authoritarian regimes, but also create 2 million new jobs. Key steps include phasing out fossil fuels by 2040 and transition entirely to renewable energy, such as solar, wind, water, and geothermal sources. They explicitly exclude nuclear power, which they do not view as renewable.
Aš nežinau, ką tu rašiai, su opt, ten nieko man nepadeda, tu daug ką rašiai. Ta prieš tai lūtė su opt-in principu, kad kas nori prisijungia, kas man tai nieko nesako, aš nežinau, apie ką tu kalbė, aš nežinau, kas tas yra. Tu nepaaiškinai nieko, kad paaiškintų žmogus, kuris nežino, kas tas yra. Tu klausi, ką tu, aš nežinau, apie ką tu kalbėsi.
The Greens want to dedicate at least 10% of the EU budget to biodiversity from 2026 onwards. They also aim to transform agriculture to support local production, ensure fair income for farmers,
šiekauju,
and
protect
them from unfair competition from international competitors. Additionally, they want to fight animal cruelty. In transportation, the Greens propose a European climate ticket to unify and subsidize public transport across the EU. It really goes without saying that the Greens have the most comprehensive plans for addressing climate change. And if you want more detail, there's much more in the manifesto.
Epatestas, mano balsas? Jo, mano balsas LT šičia.
Next up is economy.
Because we Greens, we are clear. We want industry in Europe. A thriving, strong industry and an EU that can compete globally with the US and China. An industry that builds our windmills, our trains and our chips. An industry that makes us strong and independent from autocrats and dictators like Vladimir Putin all around the world.
Putin.
An industry that safeguards our security. We want an industry that puts the bread on the table for millions of Europeans without polluting air or water.
The Greens propose a substantial investment plan of at least 200 billion euros annually to benefit the European people, the planet, and the economy. This will help achieve climate targets, such as installing solar panels on all suitable roofs and creating millions of quality jobs
in
construction, energy and transport
sectors.
The Greens want an EU-wide minimum income to prevent poverty and want to make European unemployment insurance.
Nu, tipo, kai sprendžia problemą, vietoj to, kad vetuoti, ai, čia apie vetų iš vis kalbi, kas nenori, tas tiesiog nedaro, o kiti gali daryti netrukdami. Nu, pavyzdžiui, su Vengrija jį netrukdytų, nes Europa galėtų nuspręsti be jos, o jį neprivalėtų. O tai palauk klausimai, kurie reikalautų vieningumo, tai tada, blembo. Nežinau, skamba kaip sprendimas, kokie minus, kodėl to nepadarė, nes pala. Nu gerai, jeigu viena nenori, tai tada jie kaip net ne Europos Sąjungoje, tai kokia prasme iš Europos Sąjungos, šia, tipo... Jeigu mes nesutarėm ir nedarom O kas nenori, tas nedaro, tai tu tada kam esi Europos Sąjungoje, tam, kad, tarkim, gautum benefitus, kuriuos tu nori, bet tada jokių atsakomybių neturi. Ne, ne, pala, ne. Jo, čia skamba kaip undermine vapšė, kam ta Europos Sąjunga reikalinga. Jeigu mes Europos Sąjungoje esam ir nusprendė visos, o tu vien nenori, nu, tough luck. Bet opt-in daryti atrodo weird. Visi darytų, ką nori, neieškotų kompromisų, true, irgi geras pointas. Neincentivizina šitą... šitas būdas nesukuria incentivo actually kompromisų ieškoti ir tartis ir atrodo... Tiesiog visi darom, ką nori ir tiek, tai kas Europos Sąjungos nėra tada, I don't know.
A permanent safety net. They recognize trade unions as crucial partners in securing higher wages and better working conditions and vow to support their rights and democratic functions. Regarding taxation, the Greens have a lot of plans. They advocate for an economic model that prioritizes people and the environment over corporations and the ultra-rich. This involves reforming the tax system to introduce a minimum tax on capital gains, an EU-wide wealth tax, ending tax avoidance by multinationals, and a financial transaction tax. These measures are intended to lessen the tax burdens on workers. Now, when it comes to social issues, the Greens are committed to protect the rights of women, LGBTQIA+ individuals, and racialized groups. They want to dismantle what they call the patriarchy and ensure everyone has control over their own bodies, with access to necessary healthcare and the right to choose their gender. Additionally, the Greens push for wage equality, ensuring equal pay for equal work for all genders across all areas of employment and public life. Now finally, what about EU reform and enlargement? The European Greens support the EU, but acknowledge its shortcomings and are pushing for significant reforms. They advocate for a shift towards a more federal structure by increasing the powers of the European Parliament, expanding the EU budget, and enhancing EU authority in areas like health, tax, and social protection. They propose abolishing national vetoes in foreign policy, tax matters, and the use of Article 7, where a member state's voting rights can be suspended if it breaches the rule of law. This makes me think that this might have something to do with Hungary. Furthermore, the Greens believe the president of the European Commission should be elected by the European Parliament rather than appointed by national leaders. And lastly, the Greens are very supportive of the enlargement...
Okay. Ne, jo, tai čia mano pozicija ir buvo tokia, nes aš galvojau, tipo, žmonės rinktų. Ne, čia parlamentas rinktų, tas pakeitimas yra. Ne dabar valstybių lyderiai, tipo, nu, aš už tą esu. Aš, jo, kad mūsų išrinkti į parlamentą, tada rinktų, sure, kaip Seimo pirmininką vos nekad rinktų. Aš už tai esu. Netaip iškai supratau tą. Nu, blin, not gonna lie, šitie skamba good. Problema yra ta, kad aš nežinau tiksliai, ar čia ne per radikaliai yra tas, davai keičiam taip drastiškai visą, žinai, Europos Sąjungą ir ten link federalizmo judam. Aš nesu tiek gerai informuotas, aš nežinau visų argumentų už prieš, nežinau visų niuansų. Nu ir aišku, čia per vieną dieną nepadarys to, bet gal į tą pusę aš būčiau už, kad į tą pusę bent pajudam biškiuką. Nes jeigu nors biškį nuėsim į tą pusę, man atrodo yra gerai, bet... Ar viską taip iškart padaryti, jeigu ir galėtų? Va čia klausimas, aš nežinau tiksliai, bet skamba reasonable man šita grupė bent.
We are now at the crossroad of continuing the Green Deal or go back to a fossil standstill. For democracy or autocracy. We are also for a strong Europe or a divided Europe. Really, these elections matter massively, and we need you again to fight for a strong Europe.
Nu, tai tas, pala, tai visi prisimenat, mes ką apie žaliuosius kalbam dabar. Ten yra tas Volt ir ten, kas ten dar buvo, dar vienas. Nu, taip, bet dabar mes kalbam apie kurtinės rašę. Tas Voltas, tas vidurinis ir dabar žaliai, bet mes kalbam apie žaliuosius dabar.
For a Europe that delivers on green and social policies and a strong Europe that protects us.
And that's an overview of the Greens' plans for Europe. Craving more detail? Then dive into their very detailed manifesto in the description. We are super excited to bring you a series of 7 videos.
Jo, taip pat ten pradžioje, aš tą prisimenu, bet čia irrelevant.
Together, 3 Francis there's the European Greens, which includes parties like the German Greens, France's Europe Ecology, and the Swedish Green Party. They're all about green left-wing politics. Next is the European Free Alliance, representing ethnic minorities and separatist movements, including parties like Belgium's New Flemish Alliance and the...
jų visos tos pozicijos ir yra kaip apibūdina. Tipo, nes šitie labiau už ekologiją, šitie labiau už socialinės tos pusės ir žmogaus teisų prisėda ir tada tie iš tų žaliųjų energijų ir panašiai, bet realiai tai programa, ta, nu, ne programa gal, bet tipo ir sueina į tas, va, nu, tą jų direkciją visą.
Left of Catalonia.
Aš taip supratau.
Europa, a pro-federalist pen...
Jo, prof... Nu jo, tipo, tai galų gale, aišku. Nu jo, jie jau labai į tą pusę. Bet gerai. O čia palauk, kur yra video Greens Plan for Europe, bet tai čia Far Right Plan for One for Europe, ar čia tokio pačio formato video? A, ne, 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 va, pavyzdžiui, Plan for Europe, Plan for Europe. Turbūt taip vardino. Defense and EU reform renew Europe's plan for Europe. Ir kurį dabar žiūrim? Sovereignty and no migration. ECR's plan for Europe. Tai čia ECR yra šitie, pavyzdžiui. Gerai, pažiūrim kitoj spektro pusėj, pavyzdžiui. Kitoj spektro pusėj pažiūrim. Tada žiūrėsim galbūt EPP per vidurį, tarkim, ar kažką ten. Bet dabar pažiūrim tada...
We live in a time in which everything we stand for is under attack. Our individual freedom is under attack.
Oh,
our
God.
Rights are under attack. The sovereignty of our nation is under attack.
Ai, čia, ai, tą pamenu. Meloni pamenu, Džordžiją.
The prosperity and well-being of our family is under attack. The education of our children is under attack. In front of this, people
understand šitą.
That in this age, the only
Ligoniuka.
Way of being rebels is to preserve what we are. The only way of being rebels is to be conservatives.
Giorgia Meloni is a key leader in the European Conservatives and Reformist Group in the European Parliament. The group unites right-wing conservative parties with similar ideologies from all across the EU. So find your country on the screen to see which of your national parties aligns with the ECR group.
But Christian Families Alliance, čia kuri pas mum? Pala, čia šita... Ne, pala, Krikščionių sąjunga čia kaip? Ne, Christian Family Alliance. What the fuck is this? Ta žuvis. Pala, Lenkų čia? Aš nemoku logo. A, jo, Krikščioniškų šeimų sąjunga pas jūs yra. Ai, čia Tomaševskio. No. Nu, aišku, mes žinom, kai kita pusė eina, obviously.
Basically, what this means is that when you vote for the Law and Justice Party in Poland, the Brothers of Italy Party in Italy, or Vox in Spain, you're essentially backing the ECR's master plan for Europe. And this is why this video is so important, as we will explain what they're all about. Now, before we dive into their detailed proposals, let's quickly look at the structure of the ECR group. The ECR group consists of two European parties, the ECR party and the European Christian Political Movement. This means that your national parties might align with either the ECR or the ECPM party, both of which are part of the ECR group. Additionally, national parties like the Finns Party sit with the ECR group in the European Parliament, even though they aren't directly affiliated with a European party. Keep in mind that European parties and national parties may each have their own election manifesto. Yes, this might sound a bit complex, but here's the good news. The ECR group has managed to align on a list of priorities, which can be found on their website and which we'll dive into today's video. As with all of these videos, we are focusing on six areas, starting with defense.
Pamėginam, nu, tipo, žiūrėk, pamėginam šitaip žiūrėti. Greičiausiai tai yra žmonės, nu, kurie tikrai nenori sunaikinti Europos Sąjungos. Gal yra pavieniai, nu, bet greičiausiai nori gal biškai kitokį Europos Sąjungą turėti, negu mes. Bet pamėginam tiesiog sužinoti jų argumentus, kad žinotumėm, tipo, ne kad tiesiog nurašom, kad jie duchai, bet kad actually žinotumėm, ką jie nori padaryti ir kodėl mum tai netiktų, pavyzdžiui.
Are is strongly pro Ukraine, advocating for increased aid like weapons.
Mes, pavyzdžiui, vat, galų galia yra pro Ukraina, ne?
Along with tougher sanctions on Russia. They believe in providing aid until the occupiers are defeated and extending help to others facing oppression, such as the people of Belarus.
Ultimi 5 anni in quest'aula abbiamo parlato molto di più di monopattini elettrici e farfalle che di geopolitica e di difesa militare. L'idea di rendere più saldo ed efficiente il pilastro europeo della NATO serve a rafforzare anche l'alleanza atlantica.
Un stipro NATO military, sure.
Non scandalizziamoci quando Trump viene a svegliarci dal nostro sogno verde. Non possono essere sempre gli altri a pagare o a morire al posto nostro.
They emphasize NATO as the primary security actor, pushing for stronger EU-NATO cooperation by boosting defense budgets, advancing technologies, and training forces. They do maintain that defense and military preparedness should remain with the member states and are very skeptical of an EU defense or army. However, there is some internal disconnect in the...
Palauk,
turiu
balandžių
pizdydot.
Motherfuckers. Girdžiu, kurva. Du, vėl. Jie mane ten penktą ryto prižadina, pradeda ten tą savo garsą leisti. Taip annoying yra. Prieini, atidarai langą ir kažką nuskrenda. God damn it. Okay.
The group. With the...
Karavo, tu į tūliką per streamus vaikštai? Gal kažkada ir esu nuėjęs, bet tipo, nežinau, prieš streamą nuėjai ir tikrai gali ten keletą valandų neiti tūliką, nežinau, nėra problemas, net negalvoju apie tai.
Co-president from Maloney's Brothers of Italy, bringing the idea of an EU army right back on the agenda, nonetheless.
Ne, pažiūrėjau, nu, ką turbūt galim tikrai pasakyti tom, nu, visom tom right-winger ir dar, nu, tipo, tokiom partijom, kur, tipo, nacionalistai viską, nu, jie užstiprė kariuomenį visą laiką, jie tie karo, tipo, kai vyksta karas, tu nori, kad jie būtų tavo pusė, žinai. Nes jie turės ginklų, turės ultranacionalistų ten visokią savo grupuotę, žinai, kurios, nu, eis ir gins savo, žinai, valstybę. Jie tikrai turi vertę ir tos pozicijos yra gan griežtos, bet jos turi vertę, jeigu ypač tau grėsmė kyla sienom. Neveltų ten ir, žinai, ukrainiečius kaltino ten pradžioje, kad, o, ten pas jūs naciai kovoja, nu, pas jūs yra ir tokių batalionų. Ten žmonės, kurie pasiryžė mirti už savo įstikinimus ir tėvynę, ko galbūt būtų trūkumas toj liberalioj pusėj, žinai. Tai šita dažniausiai pusė būna, jo, kaip ir čia matos, ir pro Ukrainą, ir viską stiprinti labai, ir sankcijas stipras, nu, šios karinės pusės, tipo, kažin, ar jiem labai priekaištų turėtum, nebent gal tada, nu, kiek griežtumas tas, ir kiek skirt. Žinai, nes jeigu norėtų sakyti, žiūrėk, čia taip svarbu, kad mes turim militarinę ten sąjungą patapti ir kiam procentų visko skirti ne žmonėm, o tankam, nu, tipo, keičiau, iš per toli. Nu, bet techniškai tos vertybės už Ukrainą paramą čia suprantama. It's fine.
The ECR is united in pushing for more EU collaboration in research, development and joint procurement of defense products. Lastly, the ECR also prioritizes fighting organized crime and terrorism. Next up is one of the hottest topics in Europe, migration.
The ECR
has some of the toughest migration proposals. They advocate comprehensive border security across all EU entry points, air, land and sea, funded by all member states.
Esmė, kad, okay, greičiausiai jų bus radikalesnės pozicijos negu mano. Bet greičiausiai geros pozicijos būtų kompromisas tarp šių visų partijų. Kad jie buvo tikrai ne visus įsileisti iki vieno ir be jokio ten patikrinimo, kai nespėjai, bet ir visiškai tikrai neįsileisti visiškai visų, kaip čia, ne visiškai užblokuoti visus nuo įsileidimo. Tai buvo, kažkur middle groundą turim rasti. Jeigu tam tikro atspalvio rudo, nebūtinai reiškia, kad turim visus užbaninti jos atėjimą, nu, atėjimą. Bet tai nereiškia, kad visiškai visus įsileis, nes jie tokie. Nu, tipo, vėlgi tos pozicijos, kur labai kategoriškos, realiai ir būna tas, nu, kompromiso būdu ir yra priimami sprendimai, bet Okay.
They support reinforcing agencies like Frontex and Europol and conduct joint naval missions to block migrant departures from Northern Africa. They're firmly against redistributing migrants across the EU without the receiving country's consent and want to increase the return of rejected migrants to their countries of origin.
The EU needs a deportation mechanism. You're an African head of state enjoying foreign aid from Europe.
Well, tipo, žinot, blemba. Tokį vat video pažiūrint, galima, žinai, manyti, nu žiūrėk, visai gal ir neblogos idėjos ir viską. Problema dažniausiai būna tame, kad blemba, šalia to, ir vat tose partijose būtent, tu turi tada žmonės, kurie pas mus lokaliai tenais, klikia ir sąmokslo teorijas visokias, vos ne Orlausko lygio, arba Gražulio lygio per debatus lygio, nu tipo, jie šalia turi psichopatiškų nesąmonių savo smegenyse. Ir valio, tu už Europą ir migracijos griežta tipo kontrolė, bet tada dar šalia tu galvoji, kad chemtrailai ir come on, nu tipo, tu atmeti, nu atsisakai daug rinkėjų. Ir ten žinai, jo, valio, Europos Sąjungoje jūs pozicijas gal ir normalias deklaruojat, bet tipo, nu, tu lokaliai nebalsuosi už tokius niekad ir čia, vat, tame yra problema. Kad šalia tų reasonable pozicijų kai kurių, nors ir griežtų, bet reasonable, yra ir labai nereasonable pozicijų daug. Reik suprasti, kad yra migrantas, yra savo sveikia ir pagal tarptautinę teisę, kiekvienas migrantas norėtis gaunti... Asylum turi būti suprocesuotas pagal tai, ar jam gresia kažkokia grėsmė jo kilmės šalyje, paprasti migrantai yra tiesiog tie, kurie keliauja tarp šalių, čia skantant. Kom čia keičia kažką, mes apie tą nešnekėjom, mes kaip ir žinom, kad yra skirtumai. Dešinės partijos labai skleidžia naratyvą, kad šitie du terminai nesiskiria, bet yra skirtumas. Aš negirdėjau, kad jie skleidžia naratyvą, kad nesiskiria, I guess, pas mus gal, nu, ir Šimonytė ir visi būtent pabrėžė skirtumus ir žalimas ir Šimonytė, gal pas mus aišku tas.
20,000 euros for every migrant your country refuses to take back. And sanctions shouldn't be just for Putin and other bad guys. Apply them to all countries who won't accept returns of their citizens.
The ECR is focused on combating human trafficking and smuggling. They want to collaborate with third countries so that asylum procedures are managed there, basically assessing applications for protection outside of the EU. And then there's climate change and energy. The ECR plans to overhaul the Green Deal with a more localized climate strategy that prioritizes the concerns of ordinary people, farmers, fishermen, and businesses. New regulations, they want to enforce existing ones while securing adequate funding. They also don't support banning the combustion engine, believing it can remain viable through new technology and research into low-emission fuels. They also state their goals to lower emissions, clean Europe's air, protect wildlife, and safeguard fish and seas. However, apart from using the EU's emissions trading scheme to reduce emissions, they haven't provided clear details on how to achieve these goals. They also want to support farmers.
Jo, clear details how to achieve these goals, nes tu negali tų goals pasiekti. Čia tokio kaip... Tos pozicijos čia yra kaip programą, kai skaitai. Skamba gerai, žinai, o kaip tą pasieksi? Ai, nu pasirodo to techniškai, nu... Tu mėgini sušvelnint, kad tavo pozicijos netrodytų tokios priešingai radikalios galbūt negu kad iš tikro yra. Bet realybėj, nu... Tu taip smarkiai priešingai pusėjini, kad tu negali tų dalykų įgyvendinti, net nėra kaip, pavyzdžiui, ten va tą combustion engine, tipo. Tu dabar, tu viliesi, kad atsiras nauja technologija su daug research ir staiga tas, nu, deginamas kuras nebebus toks taršus. What the fuck? Tipo, nu ne, tu to nepadarysi, tipo. O jeigu padarysit, kaip tada? Nu, neturi planų. Ir čia skamba, atrodo, labiau reasonable negu iš tikrųjų yra. Nes, vat, aš sakau, labai dažnai, aš ant sinicos tą esu sakęs, labai dažnai tie žmonės iš tos politinės pusės slepia savo power level, kaip sakant. Kad, taip, iš tikrųjų jų pozicijos yra daug griežtesnės. Jokių rūdų migrantų, ten iš karto, taip, bet jie moka gražiai pateikti. Nu, žiūrėk, mes turim reguliuoti... migrantus tuos, kurie atitinka mūsų vertybės ir okei, okay, visi kaip ir pritariam, bet tada praktikoje kokia tavo pozicija iš tikro yra kad jeigu rūdą atspalvį turi žmogus, neįsileisi, nes jisai tik iššūda ir užmušimus visus ir prievartaus moterį, žiūrėkit į Švediją, ir jie turi visą ten ir sąmokslo teoriją, ir visą radikalumą, tokį užslėptą. O tame yra problema. Ir tu, kai žiūri va, debatuose tos kandidatus, tu ir matai tą realiai, kad blembo, jie iš tikrųjų fucking insane kai kurie yra. Bet tada žiūri vat programą, kur taip politiškai gali gražiai pasakyti, kad atrodo gal netokie radikalus, bet jo, ta vat ir yra priešpriešą. Kai su kitoj spektro pusėj nėra taip smarkiai. Galima sakyti, kad jie irgi radikalus į kitą pusę, bet jie neslėpia savo power levelio. Ir jie sąmokslų teorijom netiki jokiom ten, kad ten, nu, tokių užslėptų rasizmų nėra ir dar kažką. Tai jo, tas... Man tas labiau gal patinka tuose, net jeigu abi kategoriškai būtų į skirtingas pusės, anyway.
By making the EU's common agricultural policy less bureaucratic and protecting them from unnecessary green ideology. When it comes to energy, the ECR strongly advocates for a technology-neutral approach that champions nuclear energy and aims to make the EU a leader in geothermal power. Next is the economy. The ECR commits to empower small and medium-sized enterprises by cutting down on unnecessary red tape and calling for a temporary halt on new EU rules. They want to direct resources towards implementing and enforcing existing
legislation.
To spur innovation and investment in technologies like AI, 5 and 6G, and quantum computing. Again, it's a bit unclear how they want to do this. But one thing is
what
clear,
the fuck?
And that is that member states should keep their fiscal autonomy and that the EU should not interfere in tax issues. The ECR also...
Tipo, innovation, AI, 5G, quantum computing. Maždaug įmetėm, kad atrodyt progresyvus ir už technologiją, bet ką čia reiškia? What the fuck? Kokia tavo pozicija čia?
Seeks to boost EU growth by emphasizing rule-based free trade. They aim to prioritize de-risking and take a firm stance in their relationship with China. They also want to reform the World Trade Organization and build dynamic partnerships with key allies like the United Kingdom. Now, when it comes to social issues, details are somewhat limited on the ECR's website.
Viskas limited.
Indicating a preference for these issues to be managed at a local member state level. However, the ECR generally supports family-friendly policies that emphasize European cultural heritage and respect for each nation's traditions. Additionally, they are opposed to woke and cancel cultures. Now finally, what about EU reform and enlargement?
Aš irgi esu against woke and cancel cultures. Čia vat yra tas power level slėpimas, tipo. Beveik visi išskyrus radikaliausi aktyvistai yra už cancel culture ir woke tą visą. Tai yra viskas šūdas ir nesąmonė. Bet kokios actually vertybės ir pozicijos. Tada paaiškėja, kad jie daug radikalesnės nori visos pozicijas tais visais klausimais. Bet tas pasakymas, ai mes tiesiog prieš cancel culture. Kuris yra už cancel culture? Kuris galvoja, kad tai gera idėja? Nu, tiesiog durniukai. Bet jo, tas jo, jie tiesiog slepia savo tą power level ir tie jų tokie punktai neišsako jų pozicijų arba ką jie lokaliai pasisako Lietuvos ten debatuose ir panašiai.
How do you think you are to place yourselves above the member states? One is reminded of a well-known story about Dr. Frankenstein who wanted to create a perfect being and instead he created a monster. What the report proposes okay. is the grabbing of all essential competences of the member states, thereby reducing the national institutions to ornamental functions.
So, yes, that's a very clear no when it comes to EU reform that would increase Brussels' power. That basically means no to removing member states' veto power, no to empowering the EU Parliament, no to the EU Commission becoming something similar to a member state government. The ECR say they are dedicated to protecting Europe's traditions, freedoms and values, and want the EU to do less, but better. The ECR proposes unnecessary centralization of power in Brussels, preferring decisions made closer to the people in the member states. And that's an overview of the ECR's plans. Craving more detail? Then dive into the manifesto, linked below for a full rundown. It is also worth noting that the ECR does not have a lead candidate, as they formally rejected the Spitzenkandidat system as illegitimate due to its lack of basis in the EU treaties. However, an ECR insider revealed that internal disagreements on appointing a candidate, alongside strong opposition from Poland's Law and Justice Party, influenced this decision. We are so excited to bring you a series of 7 videos in total, each dedicated to a different political group in the European...
Ok. Tada žiūrim Renew Party. Šiaip man atrodo, mes ir šiandien dieną ir skirsim tą, kiek dar liko laiko žiūrėti tiems, bent jau keletą dar noriu EPP pažiūrėti, SD noriu pažiūrėti turbūt. Nes šiai įdomu yra, jo. Ir paskui, kai debatų žiūrėsim, iš tikrųjų reikės atkreipti dėmesį ir užsirašyti, į kurią iš tikrųjų grupę jie taiko eiti ir eis. Ir dabar mes žinosim, kas tas iš visi yra ir kokį tai tą, nu, impact. Polish. Poveikį. Kokį poveikį realiai daro tai. Ok. Tai reform. Tai čia yra šitie beveik į dešinę.
Today we also need a real European power. And we must give ourselves all the necessary financial and military means to make it happen. Because Putin
Sandrogosi.
Stop in Ukraine.
Macaroni.
Our values can't be protected unless we are strong enough to overcome those who oppose them.
You just heard from Sandro Gozzi, one of the lead candidates for Renew Europe, the liberal group in the European Parliament that promotes EU defense, competitiveness, and pro-European reforms. Renew Europe comprises members of the European Parliament, also called MEPs, from across the entire continent. The way it works is that national parties from various corners of the EU join forces with other parties.
Liberalų sąjūdis Lietuvos. Gentvilas Auštrevičius, o ne? Okay, jie man abu visai patinka ir jų programa atrodė reasonable. Plačia, ta programa buvo kur 4 dienų darbo savaitę, ar ne? A, ne, čia ne ta buvo, bet ta, kur atsiliepiau, kur reasonable atrodė.
That share similar liberal ideologies. So look for your country.
Čia dabar kas priklauso, jo, kas taikysis vėliau, neaišku, aš jo.
The screen. And you can see which of your national parties aligns to the Renew Europe group. This means that if you cast a vote for the VVD party in the Netherlands, the FDP party in Germany, or Renaissance in France, you're kind of voting for the Renew Europe's master plan for Europe. And this is why this video is so important, as we will explain what they are all about. So who are Renew Europe's lead candidates? And do they have a manifesto? Well, it's the EU, so it's obviously complex. Renew Europe consists of 2 European parties, ALDE and EDP. This means that your local parties might align with either ALDE or EDP, which are both part of Renew Europe. Plus, there are national parties like France's Renaissance, which isn't affiliated with any European party, but still teams up with Renew Europe overall. Because of this structure, both ALDE and EDP have their own manifestos and lead candidates. Marie-Agnes Strack-Zimmermann from Germany's FDP and Sandro Gozzi from Italy's Democratic Party. And then there's Macron's Renaissance Party, who has its own national manifesto and a lead candidate, Francis Valérie Ayer. This arrangement results in 3 lead candidates for Renew Europe, which is quite unusual, as typically there's only one. But here's the good news. Despite these complexities, they've managed to align on European priorities, which we'll dive into in today's video. And as with all of these videos, we are focusing on 6 key areas, starting with defense.
It's 2 years since Russia's illegal and brutal attack on Ukraine, an attack on Europe. On our values. It's become clear that our security and safety isn't just a concern. It's the heart in our economy, our freedoms, and our very way of life.
Defense, defense, defense. That's Renew Europe's rallying cry, positioned as their top priority. The Liberals stand out with the most forceful language on defense among all European political groups. They advocate for a significant boost in EU and national military spending to boost defense capabilities. This includes the creation of an EU defense fund. They also call for joint procurement of military assets and the establishment of a European military academy. They want to help Ukraine triumph over Russia at all cost. And also want to deter threats from other authoritarian regimes.
So we cannot say we support Ukraine, but there can be no but, because Putin only hears the but. Instead, we must support Ukraine, full stop.
Renew Europe doesn't mention an EU army, a topic previously...
Wow, you say prieshiknas? What the fuck?
...promoted by member parties, including Macron's. However, they do aim to establish a European Defense Union by 2040, in partnership with European and NATO allies. This initiative seeks strategic autonomy, so that Europe can defend its own territory with more standardized armed forces. Next up is one of the hottest topics in Europe, migration. Liberals call for well-regulated and humane migration management. They suggest setting up EU-run facilities outside the EU to process asylum applications more efficiently. They also advocate for a shared responsibility approach, which likely...
Interesting idea. Asylum process trečiose pasaulio šalyse, taip pat ir procesinį ten. Įdomi idėja. Gal ir gera idėja. Aš nežinau, kaip tai veiktų, bet sure.
...educating approved migrants across Europe. They also aim to create agreements with third countries to prevent irregular migration flows. Regarding human rights, liberals are committed to dismantling smuggling networks, enhancing reception standards, and making asylum processes more effective and humane. They aim to launch a European action plan for search and rescue in the Mediterranean, and reform Frontex to secure EU borders while upholding human rights. The liberals call for economic legal migration pathways so that European economies can have the necessary workforce for their growth, as labor shortages are a reality. Also, good news for Romania and Bulgaria, as Renew Europe supports full Schengen accession for those that meet the criteria. And then there's climate change. And to be honest, it's not heavily detailed on the Renew Europe campaign page. While they do mention that it's time to implement the Green Deal, specifics are completely missing. But there is a dedicated section on farming, where the liberals recognize farmer frustrations. Their lead candidate, Valérie Ayer, who comes from a farming family, likely influenced Renew Europe's comprehensive action plan for farmers. This plan aims to significantly reduce bureaucracy, simplify regulations, enforce standards on non-EU imports, and increase financial support. As for energy, Renew Europe strongly supports strategic energy autonomy, with investments into renewable, carbon-neutral, low-carbon, waste-based, and nuclear energy. Next is the economy, which ranks as the second highest priority for the liberals. Renew Europe recognizes that Europe is losing ground to China and the US, so they've made a 10-point plan to boost competitiveness. Check the description for a link to the full document.
Second priority, competitiveness. We want to ensure a good business environment in Europe. Let's cut red tape. Let's make trade fairer. Better, let's mobilize private investments, not for the corporations, but for the people, for the workers, for those who want to innovate. Any hard work deserves a fair reward, but we can pay fairly only if we generate growth and opportunities.
Renew Europe wants to empower small and medium enterprises by making it easier for them to access incentives.
Not gonna lie, šitie man labai gerai atrodo kol kas. Net biški labiau balansuoti atrodo gal negu tie Greens buvo. Bet šitie atrodo, vėlgi čia kiek gali atrodyti, šitie atrodo turbūt geriausiai kol kas.
Incentives, loans and equity. They want to complete the Capital Markets Union, which will help SMEs obtain funding and hopefully encourage them to stay within the EU. There's also a commitment to allocate...
Tokie gal ne utopiniai, o realūs sprendimai, realesni sprendimai, bet kurie ir ne visai toli to utopinio mąstymo gal. Tik ne tai, kad visus įsileidžiam viską, bet davai asylumus, tos, ne asylumus, o tos padarom centrus, kitos šlyse, kur tipo, okei, okay, skambat užsiekinį tą pusę, bet actually gal reasonable sprendimas koks nors ir keletas tokių. Okei, šitie atrodo man visai gerai, Renew Europe's.
3% of the EU's GDP to research and development by 2027. Additionally, there's a strong push to provide better education and training programs, especially in critical skills areas. For example, the creation of net zero academies to help Europeans drive and contribute to the green and digital transitions. Next, there's social issues. Renew Europe champions a vision of a Europe where everyone can freely live their life, no matter their beliefs or who they love. They actively defend women's reproductive rights and fight against gender-based violence.
Sure.
They're also pushing for the recognition of same-sex marriages and rainbow families across the continent. As you might expect, though, the manifestos of more left-leaning parties, like the Left or the S&D, linked above, focus on a wider array of social policies. Now, finally, what about EU reform and enlargement? Renew Europe is a strong supporter of the EU, but they also recognize its flaws and are pushing for significant changes. They want treaty change, which is similar to a nation state changing its constitution.
And this is why we need treaty change. We must get rid of the vetoes that paralyze the Union. We must strengthen the European Parliament. We must give the voters the power to elect the President of the European Union. And citizens must vote directly for European political parties.
These are significant reforms, demonstrating that Renew Europe is true.
Remove vietą pasitrenferų parlament, one EU president. Čia įdomu, bet bre, man patinka ta idėja, man patinka čia tokia, nu, nežinau, čia tu etikečių federalizmo visko, bet man patinka ta idėja, man tiesiog patinka ta idėja. Aš norėčiau, kad pasaulis visas toks plus minus būtų kaip Europos Sąjunga, žinai. Ne tai, kad visos viena valstybė ar kažką, bet tiesiog kaip valstybės labiau kaip steitai, kad nu tas kaip pasaulis toks, žinai, mes galim rinkti, net neturėt galim ten kokio prezidento gal, o tiesiog vat kaip žinai, nu tokia pasaulinė taryba, aš mano utopija tokia būtų, pasaulis visas vieningas, bet nu, aš žinau, kad tai neįmanoma, bet tada Europą žiūrint, man patinka ta idėja. Ta idėja yra graži, ta idėja skamba įdomiai. Bet vienas prezidentas visai Europai skamba, nu, agės kaip Amerikoje, čia panašaus dydžio gautus, žinai. Būtų vienas svarbiausių žmonių pasaulyje, jeigu esu tada jau at that point. Citizens elect the EU president, nu, ble. Jo, veto, man atrodo, actually, turi eit. Ypač tais gynybos svarbiais klausimais, man atrodo, tikrai turi eit. Citizens vote for EU political parties. Aš šito gal tiksliai nesupratau, ne groups, ne political groups, o parties. Ne skirtingus parlamentarus, o tiesiog už visą partiją, nu kaip sąrašą, ar ką čia turiu minį?
Truly striving to live up to its name by wanting to reshape Europe. Notably, Renew Europe advocates the removal of veto powers, particularly in foreign policy, to enable quicker and more effective decision making. They are the only political group I've covered so far that explicitly includes this in their priorities or manifestos. Renew Europe also supports expanding the EU to include countries like Ukraine, but stresses the need for major reforms to handle a larger union.
Today we must reform the union to unify Europe, and we must promote a new global alliance of democracies for a new world order. Here we are, standing strong, more united than ever before. We are the best defenders of Europe. This is why we must renew Europe now.
And that's an overview of Reform Europe's plans. Craving more detail?
Okay, man šitie skamba gerai. Problema yra ta, kad reforminti Europą ir atnaujinti, nu, pakeisti Europą. Kas bus su tais, nu, beveik bent pusė turbūt Europos žmonių, kurie gal ne visai to nori, ar ne visai taip drastiškai nori, arba taip keisti Europą. Kas bus su jais? Ar tai realiai nepasilpna pačios Europos, kaip pasidalini, nu, tas kaip polarizacija ir pasidalinimas padidėja. Bet aš nežinau. Nu, aišku, čia nebus taip, kad per vieną dieną, tiesiog į tą pusę eini labiau. Ne, taip mąstyti turbūt čia toks baimė, tiesiog change. Nu, bet jau, okay, man šitie patinka, dar reikia EPP pažiūrėti, kur tas video? Ajo, tai man aš ir Renew Europe kol kas labiausiai turbūt patiko. Palauk, ką sakėte Renew Europe, kur tiksliai pasakė, kad eisi į Renew Europe? Ar buvo kas tiksliai pasakė konkrečiai, ne jūsų nuomonė, tipo... Aš net kaip dėmes, visgi neprisimenu. Ar buvo kas pasisakė labai tiksliai, kurie eis į Renew Europe? Nes liberalų sąjūdis tai eis, I guess, į SND, ne? Ai, ne, socialdemokratai, tu tenais. Liberalai tada gal reitų, jo liberalai dabar yra, ai. Ajo. Plin. Ai, ir tada galimai Laisvės partija, bet galbūt jie tada eis ir į tą... Nu jo, bet konkrečiai turbūt nepasisakė, aš bent jau nepamenu, nes netkripiau dėmesio turbūt. Gerai, dar vieną pasižiūrim tada tą EPP, kur yra didžiausia. Ir dabar konservatorių, man atrodo, ten yra jo. Štai, palaidim tai.
Must stand united against Putin now.
Čia bus EPP, pažiūrim toje svetainėje. Pala, Renew Europe Group, tai dabar yra Auštrevičius. Aha, jo. O EPP dabar yra Tėvynės sąjunga, TSLKD, jo, konservatoriai realiai. Nežinau, man Kubilius patinka ir sure, bet nežinau. Čia biškai, blemba, apsunkino biškų, ką man čia. Nes jie biškai, man atrodo, per daug fansiteriai. Kubilius man, pavyzdžiui, nu, kaip individas, jis man atrodo visai ne fansiteris. Bet jeigu jis, žinai, priklauso grupiai, kurie tokie kaip ir neturi, nu, čia jų tipo EPP. Ir ar tikrai jų tada norėčiau, kai jis ten būtų? Pažiūrėk žaliuosius. Mes žiūrėjom žaliuosius, taigi pirmus. Gerai, dabar pažiūrėjom EPP.
Must stand united against Putin. Now it's the right moment to build up a European defense pillar. We cannot have 180 different weapon systems, while the US only has 30.
Plakat norėjai, kad čia pažiūrėčiau žaliuosius? Kur yra greens. Jie kelių nesropė. Pala, jie kelių nes tas buvo, kur reasonable buvo jo. Tas iš... Kur jis yra? O ne, o jezu, jie kelių nes tragiškas tas, kur buvo, o jezu, ne ta pavardė. Aš sumaišiau su Auštrevičium, jo. Jie kelių nes šitas buvo. Ropė jo. Oi, kodėl... Kodėl yra greens? Ai, tai pala, ne, aš žiūrėjau, Jakeliūnas buvo tas, kur nebalsavo netgi už teroristinį steitą Rusijos pripažinimą. Tai tipo, tai jie tie holdoutai, I guess, ir yra toj partijai. What the fuck? Tai kodėl jie priklauso? Jo, wait, what? Kodėl jie priklauso? Ten? Jie tiesiog ėjo dėl pavadinimo, nes ten žalieji ir jie, I guess, turi žaliųjų sąjungą. Na čia tai Lithuania, Alliance Lithuania Independent. Tipo, kodėl jie ten? Bet jie perina kitur. Gal jie tiesiog nežinojo net kur eina, gal jie ant tiek debilai, kad aš nežinau. Okei, čia skamba. Laisvės savo Karbauskio intero pažiūrėjo po rinkimų. Why? What? Kas čia per pasiūlymai? Tiesiog po rinkimų pažiūrėjo kažką, kam, apie ką?
You just heard from Manfred Weber, the leader of the European People's Party.
Jie anksčiau liepsiminėjo žaliais. Ai, okei, tai tom ir atsakėm ir nereik žiūrėti nieko.
EPP in short, in the European Parliament. Manfred's big on...
Pala, iš naujo.
...has 30.
You just heard from Manfred Weber, the leader of the European People's Party, EPP in short, in the European Parliament. Manfred's big on beefing up the EU's defense game, including a nod towards nuclear deterrence, a key policy in the EPP's 2024 election manifesto. Now, Manfred Weber might not be the guy everyone's chatting about over coffee, but Ursula von der Leyen and Roberta Metsola? Chances are you've heard of them. They're both EPP stars, with Ursula leading the European Commission and Roberta chairing the European Parliament. But what is the EPP exactly? picture it as the most dominant force in European politics, made up of members of the European Parliament from across the entire continent. In the grand arena of the European Parliament, parties from different corners of the EU join forces with parties that have similar political ideologies. Representing center-right to right-wing parties.
Nu, tai idėja, kad jau, tu didžiausią svorį turi daugiausiai to impacto, jeigu jas turi kaip, nu, tai, kaip grupė, ta, tipo...
This means that voting for one of these local parties back home means you're kind of voting for the EPP's master plan for Europe. It's a thought provoker, isn't it? So stick around, because we're about to take a deep dive into their manifesto and what they're all about. If we were to go to the polls tomorrow, the biggest national parties in the EPP would be the CDU-CSU from Germany, bagging around 32 seats. Spain's People's Party, scooping up 24. Poland's Civic Coalition, nabbing 23. The New Democracy crew from Greece with 10. And not forgetting the Republicans from France and Bulgaria's GERB, each with 7 seats. This makes Germany the most dominant force in the EPP. Since we're diving into all 7 EU political groups, we're all about fairness here. So to help you compare apples to apples, or in this case, parties to parties, we're zeroing in on 6 key areas for each of these videos. First up on our list is defense. It's a biggie, considering everything that's going on in the world. The EPP's got a clear stance. They're in Ukraine's corner, pushing for all-out EU support, be it cash, combat gear, or diplomatic backing. Their goal is to see Ukraine through to victory and welcome them into the EU and NATO family once they've ticked all the boxes. But there's more on their agenda, cranking up Europe's defense capabilities. Short-term goals include pouring funds into defense tech that's made right here in Europe, setting up a new security and defense commissioner role to better coordinate defense issues, and creating a European Security Council, bringing together defense heads from all over the EU, plus friends like the UK, Norway, and Iceland. Looking further down the road, the EPP is dreaming big of a European defense union, with integrated European forces on land, sea, cyber, and air. These forces should complement national militaries and NATO, not replace them.
Let's build up our own defense capabilities in the next years, for example, with a European missile defense shield, a cyber brigade, or even nuclear shield. With an ambitious investments in European defense, we can keep the biggest promise of Europe, and that is the promise of peace.
Next up is one of the hottest topics in Europe, migration. The EPP wants to supercharge Frontex, turning it into a powerhouse European border and coast guard. How? By tripling its team to 30,000 strong, beefing up its authority, and funneling more funds for cutting-edge gear to boost its performance.
But it is us, the Europeans, who decide who comes to Europe and under what circumstances, and not the organized crime of smugglers and traffickers.
The EPP also wants to outsource migration to third countries. This basically means that anyone applying for asylum in the EU could be transferred to a safe third country, like Albania or Rwanda, and undergo the asylum process there. In case of a positive outcome, the safe third country will grant protection to the applicant on site. The EPP then proposes to admit an annual quota of approved asylum seekers from these third countries into the EU. Lastly, the EPP is also advocating for swift Schengen integration for Bulgaria and Romania, striving for a unified, secure Europe without internal borders. Next up is another hotly debated topic in Europe, climate change.
Lemba, aš susiduriu su ta problema, kad nu, skamba tipo irgi gerai. Skamba subalansuotai visai, skamba gerai, bet ten prieš tai klaustukai jų tipo planui konkrečiam. Bet čia kaip ir yra konkretus planas, tipo, ir skamba gan gerai irgi, ne? Ple, čia yra ta pati problema, kaip ir konservatoriai Lietuvoj. Kai tu tiek daug žmonių turi, su skirtimu idėjam, nu skirtingi tie flangai yra, nu ir skambės abstrakčiau gal biškukia, nu nes umbrella, nu po to skėčių daug turi tilt visko, I don't know. Nes šis kambarys nebuvo kol kas.
Change and energy.
We stand for pragmatic solutions, not for ideological ones. Because we in EPP, we know that there is no competitive economy without climate protection, and there is no climate protection without a competitive economy.
Does this sound like the EPP are slightly backtracking from the Green Deal to you? Well, it does to us. Not to mention the manifesto says something similar. Check out this part. Quote, "We need more technology, not bans. The EPP advocates for a technology-neutral approach to developing alternative fuels, hydrogen technologies, new powertrains for vehicles, aircraft, and vessels." There are no specifics of what the EPP plans to do. However, this clearly suggests they will avoid legislation that limits European citizens or companies, even if their practices are harmful to the environment. Yet, here it says that they are still committed to the goal of climate neutrality by 2050. But whether this is possible with only positive incentives and no bans remains to be seen. When it comes to energy, the EPP is dreaming big with an energy union, aiming to boost the internal energy market with cross-border infrastructure for gas and electricity, so that consumers and firms alike can enjoy lower energy prices. Next up is economy.
Su climate change jie daug labiau moderate iš tikro negu ten Renew ar tie Greens atrodė bent iš to.
The EPP's plan was like wandering through a maze of words without a map, but I've done my best to find the most concrete details. Top of the list, the EPP is...
Siūlyčiau nedėti per daug svorio, kai rinksas už ką balsuoti šitoms grupėms. Didžiausias problema Lietuvos MEP yra labai mažas aktyvumas, plus, kaip matom, sužalysis, kad gali visiškai... viskas metras, man atrodo, čia visai svarbu yra, į kurią partiją deklaruosi. Bet manau, aš būsiu saugus gan, kad už kuriuos aš balsuosios, jie blogiausių, kabutėse atveju, jie įsi EPP. O kiti arba Greens arba Renew, aš nematau, kurie daugiau ten galėtų eiti. Tipo, iš tos pusės aš nesijaudinu.
Is keen on cutting down EU red tape. They're pitching a one in, two out rule to slash regulation by a third, making sure every policy passes a competitiveness check to keep Europe in the race with the world.
We have to make...
Bet manau, iš tikrųjų, kai tu nežiūrėsi kažkokį dalbajobą kaip Ropė, žinai, arba Tomaševskį, į kurią jis eis. Ta grupė. O žiūrėsi, pavyzdžiui, nežinau, į Gentvilą, ne, ir jisai pasakys, kad aš eisiu kokį S&D, ar, tarkim, nežinau, tarkim, arba EPP, žinai. Tai parodys maždaug koks moderate ir kokios, radikalumo tų pozicijų, tipo. Ir ypač, kai aš renkuosi, tarp, žinai, man atrodo, jie gan gerai laisvės partijos žmonės ir ta liberalų sąjūdžio, tai keturi realiai surašai, kurie man atrodo geri. Gal visai ir aš kaip pavyzdį pasakiau, god fucking damn it. Ir gal, nes tai parodės, ta tipo, kur stovi maždaug jų ideologinė pozicija, kiek radikaliai, kiek ne. Nes jeigu pasakys, oi, mes einam į Greens, tu žinai, okei, jų pozicijos daug labiau bus ekstremalios, tarkim, negu kad, pavyzdžiui, Gentilas pasakytų į EPP. Taip, kad jis vis dėlto labiau moderate būtų. Ir va tas va jau maždaug, nes aš, štai žmonėm aš labiau pasitikėčiau, kai jie iš tikrųjų vertins pagal savo pozicijas, į kurią partijas. O ne, o, ten yra žalia, aš einu ir tada keičiu, nes aš nežinau, kur einu. Biškiuką turės svai tą tokį pozicijų aštrumą, tarkim, tų kandidatų, nes aš paskui noriu reitinguoti, aš noriu įsivinti sąrašą ir reitinguoti, tai man tas visai svarbu, man atrodo, į kurią jie,
Make business easier. We have to trust our companies to get on with what they are good at. That means less red tape, less reporting, simpler and faster procedure.
The EPP is also dreaming of a Made in Europe 2030 industrial policy, inspired by Uncle Sam, aiming for a big pot of money to support European industry. The details? Well, they're kind of hard to find. Then on finance, the EPP are flirting with ideas of a capital markets union and a banking union to pump up the financial services sector. The specifics, though, are once again hard to find. AI is on their radar too, emphasizing innovation and ethical standards without overregulation and ensuring ample funding and infrastructure support. Now, to the farming part, page upon page in the manifesto, yet it's like finding a needle in a haystack for concrete steps. The only thing that was clear is that more cash is needed for our farmers to green up and tackle climate change. Plus, the EPP are looking at setting some rules for managing population levels of our furry friends, the wolves and the bears. So what about social issues? It seems the EPP is more about keeping things steady than shaking them up. The manifesto praises, and I quote, "We are proud of our European social model, where everyone enjoys health insurance and high-quality public and social services. Where
workers have their rights protected,
and where there is a balance between social interests and market rules." The EPP does put a spotlight on a few areas. For example, championing equal opportunities for women in the workplace, or pushing for quality jobs and fair pay throughout Europe, and stronger collective bargaining, and tackling the pay gap that's causing a brain drain of healthcare professionals, especially from rural zones. Yet the manifesto hints that social policies might be best managed at the national level, rather than dictating uniform benefits or standards across the EU. Now finally, what about EU reform and enlargement? The EPP's got their sights on a European convention to change the EU treaties, but the details are pretty vague. The only clear point they've made was that they are keen on moving from unanimous voting to qualified majority voting in the field of EU sanctions towards totalitarian regimes and of the single market for defense. On the topic of EU expansion, the EPP is throwing support behind welcoming Ukraine, the Western Balkans, Moldova, and Georgia into the EU once all of the membership requirements are met. And that's an overview of the EPP's plans.
Jo, jie tikrai biškai labai moderni, bet jie vėlgi skamba, tipo, fine, nu, kai... Beje, jo, aš gal žaliu partiją, aš kad neklaidinti, gal labiau, gal reikia kuo... Nu, čia yra pati šviesiausia, realiai. Nes aš už jas nebalsuosiu, aš pasakiau, kad tai yra, man atrodo, reasonable, gera partija, tipo, ir Budraitė tikrai nusipelnė, tarkim, bet aš už jas nebalsuoju, čia jo, čia šviesiausias koks yra, aš nežinau. Aš renkuosi, rinksiuosi iš tų vis tiek ir aš ryškiau juos paskui nudažysiu, kuriuos aš actually išsirinksiu.
Koks vakaras ilgas, kaip širdį man gelia. Nuskink man jazminą.